Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched the very delayed CRS25 mission on the Falcon 9 rocket.
One, engine ignition. And liftoff. Liftoff of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket, launching Dragon on the 25th mission to resupply the International Space Station with cool science and a new advanced instrument to more effectively study our planet's climate.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Eye out on the speed on the left-hand side of your screen, that's the velocity of the first stage. We're going to see that come all the way down to zero. On the right-hand side of your screen is our drone ship. And also keep an eye out on the left-hand side of your screen for landing leg deploy.
Stage one landing leg deploy.
People real excited behind me. Right in the middle, fifth landing for this Falcon 9, 130th landing overall for an orbital class rocket.
By the time this video is up, there should have been the launch of another Starlink mission. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink 422 is scheduled to lift off today, Sunday 17th at 2:50 PM UTC or 10:50 AM EDT. There are also a couple of launches that we can hopefully expect this coming week. Next, you see that we can hopefully expect Starlink 32 on Thursday 21st at 5:13 PM UTC or 1:13 PM EDT. As well as that, we might see the Starlink 425 mission lift off on Sunday 24th, but there's no time specified. There was an article posted saying Georgia has become the latest country July 14th to approve SpaceX's Starlink broadband constellation. Eric Ralph posted an interesting tweet related to the SpaceX launch cadence over the past 30 days. He said, barring delays, this will be SpaceX's 8th launch in 30 days. This is actually not that far away from what I believe is the all-time 30-day cadence record, which is likely 10 R7 family launches from September 2nd to October 1st, 1975. Eric Berger posted a tweet saying SpaceX is launching on average once every 6.47 days in 2022. Musk responded with, cumulative tonnage to orbit this year is the right metric. Musk was asked, what do you think is the estimated time frame for creating a self-sustaining civilization on Mars? 20 years? Self-sustaining meaning not relying or dependent on Earth for supplies. He responded with 20 to 30 years from first human landing if launch rate growth is exponential. Assumes transferring approximately 100k each rendezvous and approximately 1 million total people needed. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. This new actuator was installed onto the chopstick catching arms. The chopsticks were recently raised and wrapped around Booster 7. The booster transport mount was moved to the orbital launch pad. Work continues on the Star Factory production building in the yard. In reference to an everyday astronaut video on Raptor 1 versus Raptor 2, Musk gave some Raptor info. He said, most importantly, we need to delete or firmly protect remaining secondary structure so we can remove shrouds. Tim Dodd then posted, well, I'm sure glad we mentioned the shrouds in the video. Would have been embarrassing if I left out the most important thing. Musk responded to that with, all mass necessitated by an engine design should count as engine mass, e.g. shrouds, TVC, hydraulic power and excess purge gas. Raptors in production now have electric TVC, saving over a ton of hydraulics mass on booster. Musk responded to his response with, enabling engines to take the heat without shrouds might save over 10 tons, all things considered. Shrouds are also a risk in that fuel leaks could be contained by the shroud forming a MOX bomb. Booster is purging all 33 engine shrouds in flight to prevent this. There was then a tweet posted saying removing shrouds will result in huge weight decrease. However, Elon, apart from the heat, do you think that the engines and secondary structure need some sort of protection? Let's say from dust, debris or unwanted objects. Musk responded to that with, some small tubes and wiring need to be nested in a bigger tube for thermal protection, kinda like conduit in a house. Engines themselves and booster base are extremely robust. High-strength stainless steel is bulletproof to a handgun at approximately 2.5 millimeters thickness. Booster dome is 4 millimeters. Scott Manley posted a tweet saying, "So is the electrical power for that coming from the batteries? Have you done the trades on a generator on the turbo pump shaft versus battery?" Then Musk responded to Scott with, "Electric power for booster and ship is needed even when engines aren't running, and incremental power draw of TVC isn't too bad. We have local supercaps on each engine to deal with power spikes." Raptor SN99 and SN76 were delivered to Starbase. Work has been continuing on the Starship 24 prototype to get it ready for a static fire. More tiles have been added to the Ship 24 vehicle. At some point, this drone was seen inspecting Ship 24. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, they are definitely not for Booster 7, but possibly Ship 24 static fire. There are dates for possible closures currently: tomorrow, Monday 18th, Tuesday 19th, Wednesday 20th, and Thursday 21st. Crews have continued to work on Booster 7 and inspect the engines. A Raptor engine was seen moved to the launch site and installed under B7. Booster 7 was then lifted onto the transport mount at some point. It was then rolled back to the production site for Raptor inspection. It's been moved into the mega bay for the inspection. Here's a view of the Super Heavy Booster 9 upper bulkhead stack. Here's a booster aft dome, which should be for the Booster 10 prototype. To finish up today's video, we once again have a Starbase production diagram to take a look at, thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Cantuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.